Using record type relationships, it's easy to relate your enterprise data so you can reference the data you need. Previously, I created a few record types for Acme Auto's fleet management application that I'll use as my starting point: AA vehicle, AA maintenance, and two lookup record types for maintenance statuses. You can add relationships in two ways. First, when you're generating a new data source and creating your data model, you can add relationships to existing record types. Or, after you configure the source, you can add new relationships at any point during development. Regardless of when you create relationships, you'll follow similar steps. Let's take a look at the maintenance record type. As you can see in the relationship diagram, this record type is already related to a few others. When I created my data model and added two choice list fields, the lookup record types for those list values were automatically created and related to maintenance. And Appian automatically related my user fields to the user record type, which contains all of the user data in my environment. Finally, I added a many-to-one relationship from AA maintenance to AA vehicle, so I could connect maintenance requests to a vehicle. Because I'll also need to get maintenance data via a vehicle, my next step is to add the flip side of that relationship, adding a one-to-many relationship on AA vehicle. Let's see how it's done. I'll go to the AA vehicle record type. Notice that under relationships, there's already a suggestion to add a one-to-many relationship to AA maintenance. I could just click that, but I'll show all of the steps in this video. Under relationships, I'll click Add Relationship. In the dialog, I'll search for the AA maintenance record type. Here, I'll configure more details about the relationship. Because one vehicle can have multiple maintenance requests on it, I'll keep one-to-many selected. Next, I'll identify the common fields for this relationship. A common field is shared by both record types. From both AA vehicle and AA maintenance, I'll select Vehicle ID because the vehicle connects the records. After that, I'll configure the relationship to allow writing related records. This configuration means that when modifying a vehicle record, you can allow updates to the related maintenance records. This can speed up process design and execution later on. Whether you allow this depends on your use case. In this situation, I allow updates because I can manage both vehicles and maintenance requests together. However, I might not enable it if I am referencing, say, my office location data, and I don't want changes to that reference data when someone is updating a vehicle at that office. The office location data would be managed independently in a different app. Before finishing, I can preview the relationship. I added some test data to my app so I see the related maintenance requests. Finally, I'll click Add to establish the relationship. Back on the data model page, you can see the new relationship to AA maintenance in the relationship diagram and in the list. Now, from a vehicle record, I'll be able to easily access all of the maintenance requests on that vehicle. Before I finish, there are a few other relationships I need to add. I won't walk through the steps again, but once I'm done, you can see the full view of the data that relates to the vehicles. There is lookup data for vehicle status, condition, and category. And I added a one-to-many relationship to AA comments because each vehicle can have multiple comments on it. I've also related maintenance to comment, so maintenance requests can also have associated comments. And that's all. With just a few quick steps, I've connected my data, and now I'll be able to easily reference related data throughout my application.